Hey everybody, Mike Linville here of Black Dog Education with this week's installment of Office Hours, where we answer your questions about web design, web development, and online marketing. Now this week's question comes from JD, came in off of our Facebook wall, and the question goes something like this. Mike, I can't seem to cross the HTML gap into PHP. I'm used to hand coding HTML and CSS layouts in Coda, which is just a graphical editor for those of you that don't know, but I need the functionality of PHP, WordPress, etc. How can I cross over easily? Now, we get questions like that all the time. You know, how do I do this? How can I learn to be a developer? How can I do what you do? Those types of things. And those are all fine. Those are all great. The one thing that really stuck out about this question, though, was the last part of the sentence that says, how can I cross over easily? You can't. JD, look, I'm talking to you on this one right here, buddy. You can't do it easily. If it was easy, everybody would do it, right? If you do the same thing that everybody does, you're gonna get the same thing that everybody gets. And right now, there are a whole lot of really crappy web developers out there, man. You don't wanna be one of those guys. You wanna be able to rise up above, okay? So when I'm taking a look at this question, there's really two ways that we can go about answering it. The first way is just to take a look practically at how do I solve the problem right now, right? And the question really related to how do I customize a WordPress theme? How do I integrate HTML and graphics into a WordPress theme, which is really just a series of PHP files? Or we could take a step back and really kind of get to more of the core feature, the core challenge that we have here, and that is, how do I learn PHP so that I can become a more well-rounded developer, right? It's kind of like that old saying, if you give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day. If you teach a man to fish, he'll eat for a lifetime. There is no easy way around it. You have to study, okay? We are always studying. 14 years ago when I got started, this was the first book that I read. It's about 900 pages. I read it from cover to cover like it was a textbook. I taught myself how to program Perl. We don't really use a whole lot of Perl anymore, but it was a very effective way to get me into web development and that kind of transition into PHP and then into JavaScript and then into MySQL and all that other stuff. But the interesting thing is, you know, we've been doing this for 14 years and a lot of people are like, man, you guys, you finally made it. Good job. And I'm like, no, I'm studying more now than I ever have, right? Because I understand now that my value is dependent upon what I've got in my head. How I can serve my customers. If they just want somebody that's gonna come take a logo and put it on their existing template, they can find that. They can go get that on Odesk and they can pay somebody, you know, in India $6 an hour to go do that. That's not what I bring to the table, okay? So if you like, this is JD, if you like web development and you wanna make this career, my suggestion to you, my impassioned plea to you is to do the footwork now. Don't get lazy. Do the footwork now. Study, get books, go to seminars, find what people are doing online, and really, really make it your passion, right? You really want to make sure that you focus on the study of doing the work properly. If you're into web development, a couple of things that we started out with and that we still use to this day, I want to let you know. Number one, O'Reilly books. Like O'Reilly books, technical books, Perl, PHP, Apache, those are great. You can always tell O'Reilly books because they usually have like little animals on the front. They're fantastic technical books. I highly recommend those. Always be reading. Another resource, online resource, is a place called codeacademy.com. It's C-O-D-E academy.com. Online coding tutorials that basically take you from the very beginning, like this is my name, all the way through a series of lessons that will actually help you out. And then the third resource that I really want to tell you about is, this is a great one, this is one that I actively subscribe to today, and all of my designers and developers love it. It's called teamtreehouse.com. It's a fantastic resource. They've got a huge team over there now, and they're always putting stuff together about, you know, HTML5 and programming and, you know, iOS development and stuff like that. It's a fantastic tool, and I highly recommend it, okay? Now, as a web developer, or really anything else in the market, your value, what you can charge and what you can expect to get paid on an open market, is really dependent upon the value that you bring to the table, right? What you bring to the marketplace. So for example, I'm a web developer. If somebody comes to me and they want to talk about a web design, that's great, but they're not really talking about just a design, right? In order to be able to effectively give somebody an estimate and be able to create a website that's gonna serve them, that's gonna do something for their business, I need to understand marketing. I need to understand their target market. I need to understand design and development to get it done. And then if we can't get the solution that we want out of a prepackaged solution like a WordPress or a Joomla or something like that, Then I need to be able to custom program and write some custom PHP or .NET code that will do what we need it to do, okay? As a web developer, if you've only got one tool in your toolbox, that means that you're limited, right? That means that the client has to turn around and go to other people to try to fill those other positions. Now, if you're okay with that, that's fine because that happens all the time. That's like the status quo, it seems like. Now, the problem with that kind of a philosophy is that those projects, they typically lose focus, right? You go into a project with a certain mission and a certain message that you want to get out there. By the time you get that passed to three or four different teams, it usually loses some of its focus. Those types of projects always take longer. I'm not even gonna say almost always. Those things always take longer. And you know, they are typically more expensive, okay? So I hope that you understand by watching this video, this isn't just about JD and it's not just about web development. This really is all about how do you position yourself in the market and make yourself a valued commodity, you know? When everybody else is worrying about price. If you're talking to people about price and you're competing against price, you just haven't made yourself valuable enough, okay? All right, so that's all we have today. So I wanna say thank you for your time. This is Mike Neville from Black Dog Education. And you know, if you liked this video, make sure that you like it, share it with your friends, pass it around to whomever. And if you have questions that you'd like to have answered, make sure that you come by our Facebook page. It's just facebook.com/blackdogeducation. Post your questions out there and we'll try to pull those into this kind of a format and answer those for you, okay? Again, this is Mike Linville. We'll see you next time.